Your team leaves everything on the field. They play with heart and with their mind. But being smart starts long before the kickoff. With the latest technology, sports medicine advancements, expert physicians, we can keep your team healthy and protect joints and growing bones for this big moment and their future on any field. Physician-owned Baylor Scott & White Texas Spine and Joint Hospital.
Welcome to Trinity Valley Community College, home of the Mighty Cardinals, offering hands-on education with an average teacher-to-student ratio of 1 to 20 at a third of the price of regional institutions. We teach, we strive, we succeed. TVCC. It makes sense. Apply today at tvcc.edu.
When joints begin to fail, it's more than an inconvenience. The relentless grinding pain slows you down and can even stop you from doing the things you enjoy in life. At UT Health East Texas, our skilled orthopedic and sports medicine experts are using advanced joint technologies to get you back to being you sooner with a less painful recovery. We're doing more than restoring joints. We're restoring lives.
TJC, here's how it goes. This is you. You're ready to choose your path. This is us. One of the top colleges in the nation, and it's only a third of the cost of most state schools. You apply, you get in, you choose a major. Maybe engineering, perhaps musical theater, or nursing, or power plant technology. At TJC, we've got it all, with more than 120 degree programs and certificates. You get involved, play for the team, beat the drum, all while getting the education you need. Tyler Junior College, you're ready for this.
And there you have it, McDonald's new crispy chicken sandwich. From the makers of the world's most stolen fries. The juicy chicken sandwich from the place that offers extra napkins for a reason. The tender chicken sandwich from the creators of a sandwich phenomenon. So you won't just be biting into a chicken sandwich, you'll be biting into McDonald's new crispy, juicy, tender chicken sandwich. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
A quality, affordable education is not out of reach. In fact,
it's closer and more convenient than you might think.
Trinity Valley Community College, with locations in Athens, Palestine, Terrell, and Kaufman, offers day and evening courses, online courses, and provides dual credit classes for high school students.
TVCC is also home to several national championship sports programs.
Welcome to the Cardinal Sports Network's presentation of basketball at Trinity Valley Community College. We are coming to you live from Leon Spencer Court at historic Cardinal Gym for this afternoon, this Saturday afternoon in Region 14 Conference action, the Highway 31 rivalry between the Trinity Valley Community College Cardinals and Tyler Junior College Apaches is renewed here on a Saturday afternoon in which the Cardinals have got to be aware. Tim, I bring Benny Rogers along with Tim Howard to bring Tim in. Tim, the Cardinals have got to be aware of the wounded animal theory.
Yeah, there's a lot to be said about that because this TJC team is kind of licking their wounds right now. They've had some tough goes of it lately. Trinity Valley, on the other hand, they've climbed all the way back to the top of Region 14.
They actually have. Tyler has lost five straight coming in, having lost to Kilgore, 74-49, Bossier-Parrish, 75-72, Parrish, 80-68, Panola, 70-58, and Navarro, 76-71. Cardinals have won three straight, but by benefit of the Cardinals being off Wednesday night, and Panola, who the Cardinals defeated in their last home game, lost 61-59 to Kilgore. The Cardinals have a full one-game lead in the North Zone and have the tiebreaker over Panola.
Yeah, they're at 11-2 in the conference right now. 20-4 overall in Coach Marty Levinson's first year here with the school,
and ranked 12th nationally.
Yeah, they're right there in striking distance. This team, is a lot of fun to cover. They can hurt you in so many ways.
Tim, when you look at the numbers on this game, the Cardinals are averaging 80.7 a game, giving up 70.5. TJC is averaging 67.3 and giving up 64.9. So TJC defensively has been okay. They're offensively, they struggled this year. And from three-point range, they're only hitting 22.8% of their shots.
Yeah, and they're Trinity Valley, on the other hand, is hitting 6.7 threes a game. And they're gonna launch right at 20 a game. So yeah.
In the first meeting between these two teams over at Wagstaff last month, the Cardinals won 67-56 in the game, which Tyler led throughout, and the Cardinals surged in the final 2 minutes and pulled that one out by 11 points.
Yeah, and that's the way this team can hurt you, because they can score bunches in a hurry, and they're going to try to do the same this afternoon. Of course, TJC is going to come in here and try and return the favor at historic Cardinal Gym.
In that first game, Ahmad Bynum had 23 points with the Cardinals hitting 5 three-pointers, many of those late in the contest. Makai Dorsey had 12. The Cardinals were 16 of 21 from the free throw line and hit 11 of 27 three-pointers that day.
So Trinity Valley is definitely going to go through Bynum. You know, Ahmad coming in, he's averaging right at 18, 19 a game. And so he's been one of those forces. But
he's got 75 three-pointers on the season, Tim. That's well among the conference and national leaders.
Exactly. And as you get a peek at that standing in the region north, region 14 north, you see TVCC up there. And there's some really good talent represented top to bottom. Even Bossier, they're struggling right now, 4-10. But they're a force that can, you know, on any given Saturday or Wednesday, they can hurt you.
Well, we saw him play the Cardinals tight here at Cardinal Gym before the Cardinals pulled away at the end. But, Tim, you look at this today, though. I mean, the Cardinals are where they're at. It's just not a game they can lose. I mean, you can lose it, obviously. Theoretically, it's possible. It's not a game you need to lose.
You got to take care of business. But like we say so often, when it's Trinity Valley and TJC, Trinity Valley and Navarro,
the Highway 30, Kilgore.
Kilgore. These teams have had some historic battles throughout the years, and that doesn't change today. But Trinity Valley, I think, is going to really try to go through Bynum to get him going early. That's the key.
You look at the South Zone, and Lee is setting the pace down there, and they've got to win over the Cardinals this season. So they would have the number one seed at the regional tournament if the season ended today.
Yeah.
If the Cardinals won, the season ended today, and they were both 12-2. Of course, the season's not going to end today, and there's a lot of season left.
Long way still to go. And, boy, I'm glad that this one is on the books today, because I love any time it's TVCC and Tyler Junior College. Those two, there's always a lot of fun, something to be said for that matchup.
No doubt about it. TJC, like you mentioned, TJC and Trinity Valley, Navarro, Trinity Valley, and Kilgore, Trinity Valley. It just doesn't get much better than that along Highway 31.
I'm telling you, and this one's going to be a fun one this afternoon. So buckle up and let's get ready for it. But kind of two different styles of play. You mentioned the points per game. Trinity Valley at 81 a game. TJC about 64 a game. So.
And it's just staggering. The TJC's hitting 22.8% from three-point range. The Cardinals are hitting 34.2%.
Man, that's that'll do it. You know, and a big part of that is 75 of them from Bynum, as you mentioned.
Well, no doubt about that.
So let's see how they attack things here. Glad to have you along for a doubleheader. Congratulations to the Lady Cardinals winning just a big game moments ago over Angelina Lady Roadrunners.
77-52.
And it was decided long before that final buzzer.
First quarter, basically.
Decided. Yeah, Trinity Valley came out on point, and Coach Precious Ivy and her squad get within a game of the top. And if you hadn't been following that, it's definitely not something Lady Cardinals have been a part of historically, but they're figuring it all out with a full deck of cards here.
Cardinals are coached by Marty Levinson in his first season at the college. He's been on the coach for about 12, 13 years now. And Mike Marcus is in his 24th season at TJC.
Yeah, that talk about having some history. 24 years, he's seen it all.
He's seen it all.
And a lot of it had to do with Cardinals.
And that's why I say the Cardinals have got to be very concerned about playing a TJC team that's lost 5 in a row.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that is very uncanny of this program. So
have an introduction of the starting lineups now. We'll turn that over to the public address announcer.
Monte Hill. The Apaches are coached by
TJC is led by number 22, Darius Woodson. He's averaging 12.7 points a game. Tim, he's got 31 3-pointers, which is a team high.
And now
Woodson out of Baytown, Texas.
Now the Cardinal starters. Getting a rare start is Ebra Bayou. He's averaging 4.5 points a game. He's followed by Brayton Wood, who's averaging 2.8 a game. He's got 7 3-pointers on the season.
Yeah.
Makai Dorsey's got 17 3-pointers, averaging 12.6 and 3.9 assists. Mike Bynum's averaging 18.2 points a game. He's got 75 3-pointers. And our boy Devin Franklin is averaging 7.3 points, 6.9 rebounds. He's got 20 3-pointers on the season. Does the little things that add up to big things. I know we say that all the time about Devin. It's so true. Yeah, folks, it is Region 14 Conference Basketball. This is Saturday afternoon in Athens, Texas. It is Trinity Valley. It is Tyler. And with the play-by-play, it is Tim Howard.
Thank you, Benny Rogers. Looking forward to this one. Glad to have you along. And man, if you can't be here in person, next best thing because of the great production team for the Cardinal Sports Network. Glad to be joining with you today. And they somehow they continue to let me and you be a part of it.
Oh, I know, right? I don't know what we're overstocked.
I guess so. But I'm ready for this. How about you, partner?
Oh, no doubt about it. And folks, thank you for joining us here on the Cardinal Sports Network. It's like being here, Tim, if you're watching on the Cardinal Sports Network.
I'm telling you, man, next best thing for sure. So it will be. Let's see, it's going to be Bayou in the center circle to jump for the Cards. He's out of the Netherlands, averaging 5.3 points per game. And then Wood as well, along with Franklin, Dorsey. They're all getting a chance to touch the ball.
Cardinals are decked out in their home grays today, Tim, and TJC and the visiting Blacks.
So let's see how they get this thing started here on a Saturday afternoon in East Texas. It's going to be controlled by the Apaches to lead things off.
J.J. Baden will direct the offense for the TJC Apaches.
Knocked away almost, but was knocked away, but regathered. Pass down low block, baseline jumper on the way. Count the basket for Nesmith.
Three-pointer for TJC. That's a good start and a good sign for Mike Marcus' squad.
Yeah, that's a good touch there from the sophomore. Hanging shooting, not getting a result there as good traffic there for Dorsey. Franklin tried to get the steal. Here's a three on the way.
Oh, my goodness.
Back-to-back, that's two in a row for Nesmith.
3.7 per game, so they got better than half their average on three-pointers already.
Jonah Nesmith is the only guy on the board right now. He's got two threes, 6 points for TJC.
Beware of the wounded animal, I'm telling you.
You're right. You're exactly right. Back him in a corner, you never know. Shot on the way, not there. Bayou pulls down the rebound, goes baseline, jump stop in the paint, kick out for three. Bynum. It's a roll? My goodness, shooter's roll.
Are you talking about a shooter's roll, all right?
Oh, my goodness gracious. I think he was partially out in the lobby when he let that fly. Yeah, man. Great touch here from Ahmad Bynum. Six-three ball game. Franklin closing out. Shot not there. Rebound offensively. Battle down low. It's back him in. Shot over the top. Not there. Bayou battling. TJC gets the bucket.
Oh, he's out muscling him inside that time. It's number 24, Hudson Anderson.
Yeah. Anderson gets his first points of the afternoon. He's a sophomore out of Colorado Springs. Wood passed on the three. Dorsey in the paint. Devin Franklin, right side. Three-pointer for Franklin.
Devin Franklin for three.
It's 8-6 ball game here.
That's his 21st three-pointer on the season.
Opening moments here in Athens on this Saturday. Down low, shot over the top, left it.
Devin Franklin on the defense inside that time. Oh, my goodness.
Bynum tried to get it to Dorsey. Now on the break, here comes TJC. Thought about three, goes inside. Knocked away. three-pointer from the right wing. My goodness, they're red hot. That's Darius Woodson out of A-Town. It's an 11-6 ball game. Coach Levinson wants to talk about it. So Trinity Valley on the short end. We'll take a timeout. Come back with more after this on the Cardinals Sports Network.
No one ever said you need to be sick to get better. That's why at Baylor Scott & White, we're innovating how people get well and stay that way. Where prevention might just be the prescription.
Way to work.
Teaching is on the treatment plan. And everyone is always on the same team. Yours. Baylor Scott & White Health, changing healthcare for the better.
Trinity Valley on the short side of it after three three-pointers and one shot down in the paint, 11-6.
What I've noticed, Tim, about TJCs, they're playing awfully loose today, and that's what you want to do, because they know all the pressure's on the Cardinals to defend at home court in the number 12 national ranking.
Wood goes inside but was stopped down low, so Bynum now for three. His second offering is good. Let that right leg hang just a little bit.
Pass that collection play.
He drops that one through. It's 11-9. We're seeing a bevy of threes here. That's the fifth three-pointer in the opening 3.5 minutes between these two teams. Blocking foul called here on Abreu. Tried to get there, but got his feet a little bit too, got set just a little too late there. So two-point game, going to the free throw line. It's going to be Jermonte Hill.
All 9 Cardinal points from three-point range, 2 by Ahmad Bynum and 1 by Devin Franklin.
That's actually 6 three-pointers between the two teams.
Right. And TJC's only averaging making 3.7 a game. So
they can just go ahead and stop that right
They're
now.
They're playing house money.
That's I thought you were just saying, okay, enough of that. You've hit your average, stop right there. But I think they're going to continue to play that game. 16-18 to go, and they're already at the average. 2 for 2 at the...
Tyler not playing like a team that's lost 5 in a row, that's for sure.
Yeah, they're definitely coming out really aggressive, hitting those shots. Franklin back over to Dorsey. 15 on the shot clock. 3 from the corner. Oh, he's putting it on early.
It's going to be one of those kind of days.
Yeah, I'm telling you what, here, Ahmad Bynum, we've seen him when he gets started early like that. He just doesn't stop.
No, he doesn't. We say that and he won't hit
it. I was going to say, I shouldn't have said that. I should have let the box score say it. But, man, he's so much fun to watch when he's in rhythm early. Good drive down low, getting up and going strong is Hill for 2. That's his 4th point.
6'7 sophomore out of Atlanta, Georgia.
Denham Johnson in the ball game. His shot rattles out. Not there. Back door. Franklin tried to get there, could not. So that's
a. Cardinals went to sleep there, Tim.
5-point ball game here. Mbe will check in momentarily. Lazy pass there. It's knocked away. Back down the floor. And Bayou with a block. They're going to call offensive goal.
Yeah, he definitely got it off the glass.
Or a goaltend, rather.
Well, I tell you, Tim, TJC is playing like a team that has won 5 in a row.
Yeah, I was going to say, they look like they are on the hot streak. So with 14:52 to go here in the opening half, Trinity Valley is down 7. Full timeout. We'll step away and come back with more after this on the Cardinal Sports Network.
When joints begin to fail, it's more than an inconvenience. The relentless grinding pain slows you down and can even stop you from doing the things you enjoy in life. At UT Health East Texas, our skilled orthopedic and sports medicine experts are using advanced joint technologies to get you back to being you sooner with a less painful recovery. We're doing more than restoring joints. We're restoring lives.
Eyeshadow
Your favorite thing delivered right to your door means that you never have to stop doing your other favorite thing. Nailed it. Order McDelivery in the app.
Trinity Valley trailing TJC. It is 19-12 here with 14:52 to go in the first half of play. TVCC will get Cisse in the ball game here, along with Mbe. Denham Johnson checked in previously, so it's Dorsey as well as Bynum. Bynum's been red hot, by the way.
Got 3 3-pointers.
They're going to really try to keep the ball out of his hands. Going strong. Nice pass off. Going strong with the left. Can't get it to fall. Fight for the loose balls. Picked up.
By the way, Tim, the Cardinals are out Muhammadu Cisse today. He's not suited out.
Well, they're going to miss it, that big fella. Foul on the floor here. It's going to be on Dorsey. Dorsey called for the grab.
Yeah, and this has a lot to do with the Cardinals' slow start. It's been a quiet first start of the game for Makai Dorsey. That's the first time we call his name, really. Yeah.
Dorsey is, he is definitely kind of the spark plug for this team. Usually goes through number 3. 7-point lead, TJC trying to add here. 3 over the top. Not there. That is pulled down by Denham Johnson. Here come the Cardinals. Denham on the push out, going to Cisse. Back over to Denham. Back to Johnson. Jump stop, shot not there. Man, not a good clean look that time.
Yeah, this game has started out just like the one in Wagstaff did. TJC was up 7 or 8 or 9 most of the early part of the game and leading at halftime 33-27. And the Cardinals rallied at the final 2 or 3 minutes behind Ahmad Bynum to win it.
Bynum is pretty much the only bright spot so far. Oh, it looked like a running leap.
Mike Marcus has got to feel real, real good about this start for his team.
Oh, absolutely. Coach Marcus has got his team playing at a real high level here. 21-12. Dorsey going strong. Finally, a whistle and a foul going to the free throw line after the foul is going to be called on Loudon.
Garrett Knuckles is going to check in for the Cardinals. We've seen him in the last couple of games really come into the contest and give the Cardinals an instant offense and play steady defense throughout.
Yeah, Garrett has definitely been getting it going as of late. They need his lift. So Dorsey.
Looking for his first point.
That's a free throw fly. That's good. Bynum will take a seat.
With 9 points of the Cardinals 13.
Well, he has looked really good with letting that 3-pointer fly. Dorsey trying to go 2 for 2. 77% on the year, as you see. Just 2 for 2 that trip.
Cardinals looking at an 8-point deficit with 13:09 left in the first half against TJC, which has lost 5 straight.
Now, TJC is really been trying to figure things out here of late, and they look like they have figured it out in the early moments of this one. Garrett staying on the ball. Dorsey forces him back to the right. Shot. Oh my goodness.
They're shooting lights out.
B.J. Hooper Jr. with that basket. Nicely done for Hooper.
He's averaging 7.8 on the season.
Cisse, that's tough to stop. And a foul. Boy, that's a big one there. Azalu. Cisse draws the foul. Chance for a 3-point play as Cisse will step to the free throw line. 6'6 sophomore out of Yonkers, New York. Well, look at it.
Told he wasn't going to play today, so be bad information.
Might double. Triple check my source.
Was Lucy say that? Okay, I'm sorry.
Oh yeah, Lou. That's very, very. Not very often you have two Cisse on the same spot.
I know my source is okay.
Oh man, is nicely executed by TJC up and down the floor.
TJC's got a good rhythm going offensively right now.
Woodson just catches that up in the rafters and finishes it off. Knuckles trying to get it inbound. Now gets it down low to Mbay.
Yep, he did. He definitely slid.
Shuffled that foot.
Yep.
Trying to gather himself. So an 8-point deficit for Trinity Valley here. 12:08 to go, first half.
Yeah, Cardinals are definitely going to have to defend, Tim, because TJC is shooting at a high percentage.
Yeah, they have. And you get the feeling that, hey, they're going to start to cool off. Maybe that's where it starts. Maybe. See if they can convert here. Johnson on the push. Down low. Mbay. 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 You say it enough. You're eventually going to get there. Nice job, though, by Muhammad Mbay. 6-point ball game, 11:30 to go. Oh, there's a mismatch. Phil March giving up about
too easy.
6-7 inches there. Good job by the Apaches to find the mismatch.
Yeah, Marty Levinson wasn't too happy about that mismatch either.
There's a foul down on the floor.
Literally down on the floor.
Looking at the body language of Brandon Walker. It's on me.
Got a media timeout at the 11-11 mark.
Timeout on the floor, so let's take it. We'll come back with more after this. Trinity Valley down 8, TJC, here on the Cardinal Sports Network.
Welcome to Trinity Valley Community College, home of the Mighty Cardinals, offering hands-on education with an average teacher-to-student ratio of 1 to 20 at a third of the price of regional institutions. We teach, we strive, we succeed. TVCC. It makes sense. Apply today at tvcc.edu.
Our crispy, juicy, tender chicken sandwich can make you feel a lot of things. The spicy one can make you feel, what's the word? Tingly? Yeah, tingly. McDonald's Spicy Crispy Chicken Sandwich. Order ahead on the app.
Well, we came on air today, folks, saying beware of the wounded animal theory, and so far so good so for TJC. They're up 27-19, just like they did over Wagstaff Gym. They led throughout the early portion of the game before the Cardinals rallied at the end. Kim, I was looking at halftime over Tyler. It was 33-27 in favor of TJC. We're well beyond that pace right now.
Yeah, it's been Trinity, Tyler Junior College for the most part, minus some great heroics of them. Mbay and Bynum. Other than that, it's been kind of a quiet scoring effort. 11 minutes to go here. Johnson going left. Fade away. Oh. Great athletic move from Denham Johnson.
So wow. True, so true.
That was a tough shot. Sophomore knocked it down.
Cardinals got to get stops now.
So if that D can get going here.
It's early, but you've got to set a trend and send more to TJC. So you're going to earn anything you get.
Yeah, nothing easy here. Inside, now steps back, foot on the line. Oh, pop it down.
If they're putting it up, it's going in.
B.J. Hooper Jr. I think they got that Hooper name right. Boy, he's looked good.
He be hooping.
4 points. There's a three from Knuckles. Not there. Pulled down by Hooper.
Yeah, nobody there for the rebound for the Cardinals.
Foul coming here. He gave himself up as realized this is we're going to make him earn it at the free throw line. They actually call it on the floor, so Trinity Valley definitely dodged a bullet with that one. The foul on Johnson, his first of the afternoon. Bynum will check in momentarily. Shot not there, but a foul coming against Anderson, I believe. Yeah, they'll get him on the push underneath.
Yeah, he uses an elbow to make clear space.
Denham Johnson will check out as Ahmad Bynum.
Cardinals get a stop. Now they've got to convert that into points on the other end, and Bynum's back on the floor.
Yeah, see if they get him back into the rhythm of things here. Got a well-deserved break moments ago.
Going to set up down shop down in the left corner.
What are we doing? Exchange!
They went Knuckles going driving, find him top of the circle, not there. Good hustle. Franklin gets the rebound and a foul coming on. I believe they're going to get that on Jones Taylor.
And how often do we say that? Good hustle by Franklin. You say that a lot.
Devin Franklin, man, he just does it all. And I mean, that sounds like it's, you know, I need to get another frame.
Well, it's true.
Because
he does it all.
He does it all. This is an example of it. Look, Jones Taylor had the beat on the ball.
I got some fouling as well.
Franklin gets rid of it. Bynum gets the screen shot. Fade away. Franklin almost got that one.
Marty Levinson not too pleased with the way his offense is executing right now.
No, it's like that is not what we're designing over there.
TJC's cooled off a little bit, but they get to go about 10 here with a bucket.
Three on the way. Not there. Pull down Phil March. Here come the Cardinals wanting to run, but good closeout by TJC. March going left. Boy, great defense. TJC is really nose-to-nose working on the defensive side of the ball. Skip pass out. March for three. Not there. Long rebound controlled by TJC.
Nice pass by Bynum off the drive.
Dorsey about to check back in for Trinity Valley.
Yeah, the Cardinals are going to get Mackay into the offensive flow, though.
Yeah, they need Mackay. There's a good job from Cisse. Knocked it away, Franklin, to Bynum. Here comes Alou. Alou Hank shoots. No bucket.
Good effort by the Cardinals, which has come away with points. No points is not something they're going to look for.
Bayou, Johnson, Mbay, and Dorsey all about to come in. Three-pointer on the way. That's good. Shoot. Boy, they are lighting it up from behind the arc today.
Four of the three-pointers now for our TJC.
That's more than their average. 3 points, seven, I believe, coming into today.
TJC led 33-27 in Wagstaff. It's 32-21 now with 7:45 still left in the first half.
Cisse gets a tough shot to fall as he falls. He's back up. 7:37. And it's a 9-point game.
Alou now with 5 points.
Trinity Valley needs a few stops here. Get this crowd in the game, man. It's a pretty good crowd on hand for this one and not really been able to get anything to rock them out, minus a miss here and there. Franklin with a rebound. Bynum will bring it up the floor. Approaching the 7-minute mark in the first half. Garrett, baseline over to Cisse. Bounce pass. March had it blocked off of him as he's on the baseline. Great defensive play.
Unfortunate break for the Cardinals.
Nesmith got the block and the forced it off of a Cardinal. 7:01 to go. We got a timeout on the floor. Trinity Valley in a battle with TJC right here on the Cardinals Sports Network. Trinity Valley trailing TJC by 9 here with 7:01 to go here in the first half of play.
Kim, I'm going to look to see if I can find any other women's scores from the league today. They all should be final now, so pardon my generation, so I'm not good at doing two things at one time on technology, but I'm going to try to get there.
Well, I'm looking at the highlight there. Denham Johnson had such a clutch shot, and then this shot where Cisse is going down, falls down.
Got a final score from Wagstaff Gymnasium in Tyler 80, Blinn 70.
Whoa. Now, what does that do to your standings? One game separating Trinity Valley from the lead.
Yeah.
So
only Trinity Valley.
Yeah, that's...
Well, Kilgore, I guess.
Kilgore, yeah. But, boy, it's getting interesting. It's still a long way to go in that race. Good one going here today as TJC has Trinity Valley having to go back door. Oh, man, that'll give the crowd something to ooh about. They're not cheering about it, though.
In men's action, with 11:27 to go in the first half, Navarro leads Panola 18-13.
Sloppy there. Johnson with a great effort to get back after the turnover. Made a great block. Bayou, Mbe, Dorsey, Bynum, and Johnson all on the floor for TVCC. Benny's got breaking news for us here.
Final score in overtime, women. Panola 97, Kilgore 94.
Oh, my goodness.
It's been a Trinity Valley kind of day.
It has been. The Lady Cards are going to love that. See if the men can get going here. They trail by 11. Well, 6:25 to go in the half. Way off. Johnson and Bynum. It's eventually Denham Johnson that pulls down the rebound.
Ordinarily, you might say TJC needs to be a little more selective and start not forcing up the three since they got the lead. But I kind of like it, Tim, when you're on the road like this, come in here and try to really bury the home team.
Yeah, they have had a lot of success with it early on.
They've got 4 3-pointers.
Bayou. Spin move up to the glass. Cover the floor right there.
Hard to make more of that.
Get to the basket. When it's not falling, get to the basket. So inside 6 minutes left in the first half. 9-point game. Need a couple of stops. Uncontested three. Boy, just rattles off. Mbe.
Wait, Tim, at halftime we'll have Cardinal football coach Sherry Petit to talk recruiting.
Looking forward to that. Big day for Trinity Valley earlier. Here's a shot. Not there.
Cardinals need to win this last 5 minutes, Tim, down 9 right now.
Yeah, they need something good to go their way. Fighting for the loose ball and a long rebound all the way back out. It's been that kind of a half for Trinity Valley.
It's been real lethargic, to be honest with you.
Yeah, they've got to get something going here.
Other than the 3-pointers by Ahmad Bynum early on, that's been about the only spark the Cardinals have had.
Oh, that's double. I thought they were going to get him for steps, but he was dislodged on steps from the foul. So the foul will be on Bay.
It's going to send number 30, Jermonte Hill, to the free throw line. He's averaging 10.3 on the season. Got 4 in this one.
Yeah, Hill's had his made his presence known in the early going of this. This is the first of two.
Pretty decent free throw shooter, 69%. Yeah. That's not bad.
Well, you'll take 70%. And
this is under the acceptable mark.
Right there flirting with it. 2nd one on the way. Goes 1 of 2.
10-point title lead, Tim, with 4:54 to go.
Yeah, final 5 of this first half. Trinity Valley needs to get on a run here. Get something positive for things. Here is Ahmad trying to set up a couple of defenders. Johnson fakes, now goes up, hangs, and blocked. Denied at the basket. Great defense. Foul underneath. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah.
Back and forth we go. Trinity Valley looked like they were going to have a golden opportunity there as Denham fakes one way. The defender went for it, and it opened up. He goes to the basket, but great close underneath.
A lot of this has to do with TJC, of course, defensively. But the Cardinals just can't get any kind of flow or rhythm to them offensively or get back-to-back buckets.
Yeah, points have been hard to come by. Trinity Valley has not been able to get much happening. Here's a good look at the defense underneath. Boy, he landed right on that tailbone.
So Tyler team's only averaging 67.3 points a game, and they're headed there with his 37 points now.
Yeah, still 4.5 to go in this first half.
Right there shooting 3-pointers, you can get there pretty quick.
12-point ball game, Trinity Valley trying to get things moving their direction here. Trinity Valley averaging 81 a game. Here's a 3 on the way. Missed everything. His last 2 shots from behind the arc have been way off.
If you're keeping score, that's what's happened, yeah.
4:05 left in the first half of play. Cards need a stop defensively. Get something positive happening after the defense. Let's see what they do. Kick out for three, left side. Not there, rebound, Bynum. Cards want to run. Kick out, Dorsey. All the way, up and under. Wood for three. Not there. One and done. It has been TJC controlling the boards.
Controlling the game.
Yeah, that says it all right there. They have come out and played a near stellar first half of play. 37-25.
Carter, we've got to continue to work on the defensive end.
Blocked by Johnson. That is a big lift from number five.
Got to convert now.
Lift it, missed it. Bayou, pass off to Wood. Wood for the basket. Boy, great effort by Bayou after missing it. Got the rebound and flips it over to Braden Wood.
Cardinals needed that after getting the stop.
Yeah, they needed that. Denham Johnson made a great play defensively on that other end.
Need to try to be within single digits going into the halftime locker room.
Close out this final three, see what you can do. Talk about spurts. There's a long three.
Oh,
that is a nice touch from number 22, Darius Woodson.
5 3-pointers now for TJC.
Woodson's got 15 points.
Averaging 12.7 on the season.
Up and under and then telegraph the pass. That's an easy one there for Hooper. And a blocking foul called on Braden Wood.
Long way to go, Tim, and the Cardinals certainly have got the MO to finish strong and pull games out. But every now and then teams have a lemon, and this got a lemon look to it right now.
Yeah, it doesn't look good right now. Long way to go, like you said. 13-point deficit here. Timeout on the floor. We'll come back with more after this on the Cardinal Sports Network.
Would you look at that?
It's beautiful.
Wow.
That's our boy.
Get two breakfast sandwiches like a sausage McMuffin with egg or a bacon, egg, and cheese biscuit for just $5.
Welcome to Trinity Valley Community College, home of the Mighty Cardinals, offering hands-on education with an average teacher-to-student ratio of 1 to 20 at a third of the price of regional institutions. We teach, we strive, we succeed. TVCC, it makes sense. Apply today at tvcc.edu.
Trinity Valley trying to figure it out here with 2:23 to go in the first half. You said it, Vinny. I mean, this team definitely has the firepower to come back. So far, though, TJ has had something to say about that.
No doubt about it, and I'm not going to try to harp on it too much more, but there's just something to the wounded animal theory. And TJC came in here, lost five in a row, and they're playing like a team that has won five in a row. And credit to TJC right now. The Cardinals have got to find some kind of energy and some kind of spark to get them motivated.
Yeah, they're down 13, and TJC's trying to add to that right now. They get it down on the low block. Shot on the way. Not there. Rebound. Denham Johnson skying for it. Dorsey wanting to push. Here come the Cardinals. Braden wide open. Lets it fly. Not there. Johnson gets the rebound. Finding Braden Wood going to the basket. He'll go to the free throw line as he's fouled. You know, in the act of shooting.
We've talked about the energy that maybe we're not seeing from the Cardinals today and the effort. Well, not my effort, but energy. But we're certainly seeing some energy from Denham Johnson thus far in this game.
Yeah, Denham Johnson's made a couple of defensive stops out there that were certainly going to be points and then pushed things the other way.
And kept a couple of rebounds alive as well.
Wood at the stripe.
Oh, goodness.
Missed that. They need everything right now as they're looking at a 13-point deficit. Minute 56 to go. Gets the roll there. So it's a 12-point game. Cards need a couple of stops here to close this thing out. Get something momentum-wise happening their direction. B.J. Hooper, Jr. with the ball. Now gives way to Luden. C. Skip pass. Denham tried to knock that one away. Well, he's been all over the court defensively, and they're going to need more of that from him.
Yeah, he's been a leader for the Cardinals effort-wise and energy-wise, but just more of them need to follow now.
Yeah, he's setting the pace. Timeout taken here with 92 seconds to go in this first half of play. Trinity Valley trailing to Tyler Junior College right here on the Cardinals Sports Network.
TJC, here's how it goes. This is you. You're ready to choose your path. This is us. One of the top colleges in the nation. And it's only a third of the cost of most state schools. You apply, you get in, you choose a major. Maybe engineering, perhaps musical theater, or nursing, or power plant technology. At TJC, we've got it all, with more than 120 degree programs and certificates. You get involved, play for the team, beat the drum, all while getting the education you need. Tyler Junior College, you're ready for this.
Trinity Valley on defense here is TJC trying to add to that 12-point lead. I'm Tim Howard along with Benny Rogers, and the Cardinals need a lift here, Benny.
Oh, no doubt about it, Tim. They've got to finish strong.
Right into us here.
Tim, as I look at the scoring, we've got Makai Dorsey with 2 points, both on free throws. But Tim Howard out of the TJC has done a good job of denying him his drives today, his penetration.
Yeah, they have. They've taken that away. And speaking of taking it away, I'm glad to see the scoreboard, the ad portion of the scores table come back. For a minute there, it was just flashing. Looked like me when I wake up in the morning, just crystallizing, trying, what's going on in this brain of mine? Is shot on the way.
Oh my goodness.
Good grief. That's how Coach Marquise drew it up in the break. That was right at the timeline.
Yeah, it's midcourt.
Good night. It's one of those kind of afternoons, man. It's a 15-point ball game.
6 3-pointers now for TJC.
Mbeg forces his way, muscled up, and had something to say to Woodson as he went down the floor. But they're going to need a lot more of that and some defense. But if those half-court shots are falling, I don't know how you draw that one up.
Wow.
It's a 13-point game, 50 seconds left in the first half. Shot over the way, three-pointer. They are on fire this first half. Woodson.
It's just an exhibition.
Yeah, putting it on. Wood, skip pass over. Dorsey in the paint. Goes up, hangs, foul, and free throws coming with 32 seconds left.
First time we've seen Makai on the drive today like that.
Got to get him, you know, and I know that's part of their game plan. Like you said, they're just denying it. They're keeping him from being able to, but Makai really asserting himself that time.
Yeah, it'd be hard for Mike Marquis to find something to complain about in the first half of this team.
I'm telling you, man, that was right in front of me. He was to the right of me. We let that fly and got it. Got it to go.
Run!
Although, wait, I don't know if he had his eyes up. I'm just kidding. That was brilliant, though. Just the knowing.
The shot clock wasn't about to expire either, no, right? No?
Yeah, it was. It went off as he let it fly.
Okay, I didn't catch that.
But just the awareness to have that presence of mind. Looked up, saw it, and he let it fly.
You know, it's your kind of day when that happens.
I'm telling you, man. Gets two at the free throw line, so it's a 14-point game. All things considered, if you can get a stop here, you go in crazier things, man. You're just like, you're going to have to say, all right, we're going to defend better in the second half. They're not going to stay as hot as they have. And I've said that for 20 minutes, and they have proven me wrong for 20 minutes.
It sounds like you're trying to convince yourself.
I think I am at this point. Five on the shot clock. Drive, a step back, shot, not there. So 1 point left, and that's how it'll end. 46-32 as we go to halftime. Trinity Valley trailing TJC by 14.
We'll take a break here on the Cardinal Sports Network. We'll be back with our special guest here after this break.
Prosperity Bank offers free checking. Let's take a look. No monthly maintenance fee? Check. No individual check fees? Check. Free debit card? Check. Unlimited withdrawals? Check. Free online banking? Check. Easy access and friendly service? Check. Close to home? Check. Simply free checking from Prosperity Bank is simply free. I'm taking these checks to the bank. Prosperity is the big bank with your community's bank inside. Prosperity Bank. where you find real bankers, not just a bank.
Sometimes managing your health and keeping track of all the details can feel a little overwhelming. But UT Health East Texas Virtual Care makes it easy to stay connected with your health care. You can message your doctor, see test results, pay your bills on time, and even request on-demand video visits to be seen right away from the comfort of your own home. All through your smartphone, tablet, or computer, from virtually anywhere. Less stress, more living.
The transfer portal is making things different.
Yeah.
We've got guys leaving, you know, after 1 year. We had several guys this year leave after one semester, which is good. We, you know, one of our corners signed with the University of Illinois. You know, his first day on campus was in July. Went through summer workouts with us, played the fall, and then he was able to move on. I had another corner, did the exact same thing, came in here, went through a great summer camp. Did fall camp, played the season, and then signed with Coastal Carolina. And so, you know, right then immediately we got to have two corners that we got to go find and replace right now. So that's what's kind of becoming the new norm is our two-year college is becoming a one-year college.
I was going to ask you that very thing. The portal is changing everything. From the aspect of that, how tough is it for you guys to be able to, you know, guys move on from Trinity Valley to get to that next level? Is it have anything to do with the COVID, you know, the extra year? That's got to be tough, too, because there's a lot of bodies out there and only so many.
Yeah, well, we're finally far enough away. We're kind of getting to the end of the COVID stuff, right?
We're getting there. Yeah.
You know, just with our guys is we had in 2023, Trinity Valley had 39 guys signed. At the four-year level, 27 of those 39 are at the Division I level. So we're doing a heck of a job. Our coaches, our academic support, our professors, everything's going in the right direction of getting our guys where they want to be.
Right.
We just got to continue working and getting better on the football field.
Oh, I know one of the big areas you need you had is along the defensive line, and I think you signed 13 or 14 kids there. Talk about that group that you think you're bringing in.
Yeah, so even kind of our two deep this past football season on the D-line, where, you know, when we were rotate those four in and then rotate the next four in, those were mostly sophomores. And so we had to kind of replace that whole unit. So we did. We were able to go out. We've signed, I think, six defensive ends, and we got seven interior kids on the D-tackle. So On the edge at the defensive end, we got some length with some speed rush, pass rush, that type of situation. And we got some bigger, some girthier big bodies to kind of they'll stop the run on the interior.
You also signed a couple of Henderson County fellas, about three players, right? Yeah. One from Athens, a couple of those Tigers. And they've been doing a lot of fingertip push-ups getting ready for those rings, I understand. Yeah, talk about them for a second.
No, it's always good when you can get guys that are local, and I always talk to them through the recruit process. Is sometimes it's hard to be local because whenever you've got responsibilities, whether it's study hall or practice or whatever it may be, you've got those buddies that don't have those same responsibilities, and they tug at you to go do the wrong thing at the wrong time. But we kind of talk through that. But no, I'm really excited about you got. I think the 3A Defensive Player of the Year and Doc Renberg from Malakoff at defensive end for us. We've got the 3A Offensive Player of the Year and Chauncey Hogg will play receiver for us. And he's a really good defensive back in his own right as well. And then he's also adds the value of the kick return on kickoff return and in punt return. And then, you know, you come back here closer to campus, and we got Jamari Manning, he's been a really good football player for the Hornets, and he can do it on both sides. I know this year he was solely a kind of a running back. They felt the need. They needed him on the offensive side, but in the years past, he was able to play some safety, some of that rolled down nickel, maybe outside backer. So we're excited about what he will do in the future too. And then we'll just kind of let's get him on campus here in July and see what happens.
I never thought I'd see a Sheridan Fatigue signing class that didn't include a quarterback.
Well,
talk,
you know,
quarterback room.
Really, you know, we're really excited about Diego Tello is on our team right now, who was a kid that was here with us last year. So he's been able to go through summer. He's been able to go through the fall with us. He's been that guy that, you know what, he's going to be really good. Got a chance to be really special. So excited about what he brings to our team. We were able to add at semester Champ Harris, who is a transfer from the Army. He actually played in 8 games this fall for Army at quarterback. So he's got a little experience there, able to bring that in. He's originally a Florida kid, and he's a good-sized young man. I mean, he's 6'2", probably 210, 215 right now, who played a lot last year as a freshman. So with him and Diego was the experience. Diego came to us from University of Texas San Antonio. So kind of got those two guys, and then we got kind of a not too far down the road and from Crockett, Texas, Jaden Collins, who is really athletic. He was just a little raw coming into that freshman year, was able to, he's got an arm and he can really run, and he's just gotten better on his time on our campus. So I'm really excited about what he's going to be able to do this spring once we get spring break over with and we head back to practice and again to see kind of his growth as we go into his second go around here.
Well, I'm glad to hear from you on that, because I've been in kind of in mourning since the Super Bowl ended football season last week, and I'm looking forward to football already.
What are your spring dates this year? You have a set yet?
So we will start, you know, we get back from spring break in March, and then we'll kind of take a week there to kind of get through meetings and install meetings and that sort of stuff. So the last week of March, and then we'll practice through April. And I think we'll finish it up the last Monday in April, which is, I think, Monday the 29th. I think we'll kind of have our spring game on that Monday night. And that'll kind of be the kickoff to the finals week.
So before we let you go, we appreciate you stopping by today. I know you've had some adjustments on your coaching staff. Talk about some
new things. Yeah, we've had some things go, and sometimes it's bad, sometimes it's good. But I tell you what, we've had some really good things happen on our staff. Our defensive coordinator, Mark McMillan, who has done a really good job for us, was able to take himself and take a Division I coaching position. So longtime assistant, very knowledgeable, really good football coach, Blake Bryan, who's been our special teams coordinator. So he's been running a side of the ball. He's going to slide over and be our defensive coordinator heading into the season. We got to bring back Tyrell Thompson, who played for us back in 16, helped win a championship, and then go on and finish off at Tarleton State. And then he's kind of been playing some arena football and some different things like that. And so we're getting to bring him in to coach our defensive line. And then another former Cardinal who I was able to coach in 2010, where Josh Johnson, who was MVP of our league back then in 2010 as a running back, and we've added him to our staff. And so he's doing a really good job. He's just one of those young guys that show up and finds work.
Well, Poe, we thank you for dropping by. Congratulations on the signing class again. It was a great class.
Always is, you know. Always is. We just need Tyler down to kind of hit a cold spell and our guys to get hot, because I don't know if they missed a bucket this first half.
I was going to say they didn't. And you've had some discussions down a couple of touchdowns at halftime. What do you as looking at the score? It's like
keep 14. Shooting, right?
Keep shooting. Hey, appreciate you, Coach.
You
always good to
it.
See you. We'll step away. We've got the second half coming up here right after this on the Cardinal Sports Network.
Welcome back, Trinity Valley athletes. Baylor Scott & White Texas Spine & Joint Sports Medicine is here to keep you going at full force. Our commitment to helping athletes perform at their best on and off the field is our core strength. Whether it's orthopedics, performance, or wellness, physician-owned Baylor Scott & White Texas Spine & Joint Hospital is your choice for better health in East Texas. Just like every hard-driving Cardinal, we're focused on excellence every day.
Prosperity Bank offers free checking. Let's take a look. No monthly maintenance fee? Check. No individual check fees? Check. Free debit card? Check. Unlimited withdrawals? Check. Free online banking? Check. Easy access and friendly service? Check. Close to home? Check. Simply free checking from Prosperity Bank is simply free. I'm taking these checks to the bank. Prosperity is the big bank with your community's bank inside. Prosperity Bank, where you find real bankers, not just a bank.
And we are back at Leon Spencer Court at Cardinal Gym. We are at the end of halftime here, and it is not looking good for the Cardinals right now. They're down 46-32. TJC has come out and played very loose, been very good from the three-point range, having hit 7 3-pointers in the first half. And, folks, they're only averaging 3.7 a game from three-point range. So Cardinals have got a lot of work to do. It can be done. The Cardinals were down at halftime over at Wagstaff. That score was 33-27, so they've got a bigger hill to climb. But no doubt the Cardinals can do it. They have finished strong in some games this year. It's just that they've got to get going. They've got to get Makai Dorsey going. He had 4 points in the first half, all from the free throw line. The Cardinals were led in the first half by Maude Bynum, 9 points, all on three-pointers. But all three were early in the game. So he had a quiet second half of the first half, and that's how the Cardinals have found themselves down now 14 points here as the first half, as the halftime of it's about to end. The Cardinals will be on the road Wednesday, going to Corsicana to take on a Navarro team that has suddenly gotten hot and was beating leading Panola. Last score we checked, it was early on, it was 18-11, but Navarro has gotten hot now. Grant McMillan has got his squad together, and they'll be a tough out for the Cardinals over at the Woolen Center next Wednesday night at 7 o'clock. And the Cardinals will be at home next Saturday taking on Kilgore here at a 4 p.m. start. And Kilgore defeated the Cardinals the first time around. That score was, as I struggled to find my score sheet, that score was 99-83, that game over at Master Gymnasium last month. It is 46-32 at halftime, and with the second half call, here's Tim Howard.
Thank you, Benny Rogers. The Cardinals going to try and find some power and get this thing moving in the right direction. They have definitely got it, but sometimes it's just, you know, when you're hitting half-court zingers, I mean, it just kind of gets to be, it's not your day.
Yeah, I'm not writing this one off.
No.
But sometimes there are lemons in life.
Yeah, that's true.
And right
that's
now,
true.
This was not looking good.
Let's see how they respond here coming out of the break. On the floor, it'll be Wood, Dorsey, Bynum, Bayou, and Franklin. Your original five for Trinity Valley.
Tim, I was saying before you rejoined us, the Cardinals have got to find a way to get Makai Dorsey got going and involved in the offense since he controls and directs the offense.
Yeah, they've got to get him going. They started to do a little bit more of that at the end of the first half. Quickly out to Franklin. Franklin pulling the trigger, not getting it, but the putback by Bayou just hard off the cylinder.
That kind of day.
There's good hands by Bynum. Picks it up, trying to get numbers. A drive, shoots the left, not there. Bayou used his head to get that one to go.
I was waiting for you to call it a header.
A header. I was thinking the same thing. It just wouldn't come out of my mouth. Franklin will go to the free throw line, though. That's predicated by the defensive stop there.
Absolutely. You've got to convert when you get those stops, certainly when you're looking at a 14-point deficit.
So Franklin will step to the free throw line.
Devin's got 3 points on a three-pointer.
See if they can get him going here in this second half as Trinity Valley is starting to get a couple of rolls themselves here.
Cardinals had 4 3-pointers in the first half. TJC had 7.
That just is...
One from half court.
One was a half quarter as the buzzer was going up. Not the halftime buzzer. A shot clock violation he saw.
I somehow missed that.
And lets it fly, gets 2 for 2. Cards trying to bring some heat defensively. Only a 12-point game here, but boy, it's just been hard to get points to come. And
it's going to have to happen on the defensive end for the Cardinals, Tim.
Yeah.
And they're not going to be able to shoot their way out of this one, I don't think, unless they get some stops.
Yeah, TJC has just been able to get points in rhythm. It's been one of those kind of days for them. I mean, they come in having lost 5 straight. But you said it. They look like they've won 5 straight.
Hey, they absolutely do. The way they're playing today.
They are looking pretty incredible. Cards working hard on the defensive side of the ball, though. Trying to get another stop here. They need to get this crowd in the game. They know that. But that makes it easier. And Franklin almost did it at the buzzer. That won't go. Picked up. Here comes Dorsey. Numbers 3-on-2. Out front to Wood. Go strong. Off the glass. And one. 46-36. What a play from Braden Wood.
Man, what was the call, though?
No call. 10-point ball game.
I think that'll be the spark to get the Cardinals going.
I'm trying to get this crowd into it. Going stronger. But now a whistle on that.
Yeah.
There's a whistle on that.
And Marty Levins is saying the exact same thing as you are, Tim.
Yeah,
it's
he's
the exact
pointing.
Same thing on the other
a
end.
A little surprised. Doris is saying the same thing as I'm saying. And
wow.
And that's unbelievable.
That's unbelievable.
That really is. He cracked his skull on the hardwood after that one. 1832.
We don't practice homerisms here.
No, we try not to. Try not to. Marty Levinson made his point.
Marty's going to talk him into a call eventually. You watch. That'll talk him into. They'll get a call.
He's right.
Well, he's right.
It's like the guy on the other end gets his head
and
cracked open.
Marty's not one to work the official.
No, that's not his style at all. Second free throw up and good. It's a 12-point game with 18:32 to go. Wood getting inside, drops it off in traffic. Franklin gets on the floor, and now timeout taken. They had to burn one here.
Yeah.
So with 18:21 to go, it'll be a 12-point lead for TJC at the break. We'll step away. 60-second timeout. More after this on the Cardinals Sports Network.
A quality, affordable education is not out of reach. In fact,
it's closer and more convenient than you might think.
Trinity Valley Community College, with locations in Athens, Palestine, Terrell, and Kaufman, offers day and evening courses, online courses, and provides dual credit classes for high school students.
TVCC is also home to several national championship sports programs.
Trinity Valley coming out with a lot more energy here in the second half of play. First minute and a half gone by, and it's a 12-point ball game.
They need more than energy.
They're going to need a lot.
I mean, they need energy, yes, but they need to put some.
Well, it looked like they're starting to see some things transpire here. But as we look at the replay here, that timeout taken, they had to burn one.
Yeah, I'm not usually a big fan of saving the possession this early into a half or anything, but maybe
you might have to get back into the game, or that timeout may not matter. Is what I
exactly?
I think you're getting.
No, that's what I am. I took a long way there.
Well, I didn't help things by throwing a roadblock at you.
You took me there.
My bad. This is a 12-point ball game. Cards with possession, and Bayou takes the ball. See if they can get Dorsey going here.
I think he's got to get involved for the Cardinals to have a chance.
Bynum can't get it to fall. One and done. Here comes TJC. Numbers up and left it short. Braden goes and gets it, but Bayou kept it alive. They're going to oop it to Franklin for the stop. Devin Franklin making it happen. But how about the pass from Wood?
Makai Dorsey with the drive, wasn't it?
Or Dorsey, rather.
Yeah.
That was beautiful. He is the key, like you said. They get him in the flow of things. Things start happening so quick. Baseline drive. Reverse is blocked by Franklin. Wood picks it up, trying to run it. Pass off Bynum. Sizing him up. Driving. Left hand is good. Ahmad Bynum. And a quick timeout from Coach Mark Reese.
Oh, Got to have it. He feels what we feel.
Yeah, he knows it's coming. They're going to burn a 30. So Ahmad Bynum makes it an 8-point ball game. Benny, let's keep it right here and talk about this. As, we're talking about the things you've got to have go right. What has happened thus far that's been right?
Well, suddenly TJC's not getting the rolls on the rim right now. They've had three attacks from close point-blank range, and the ball is not falling in, and Cardinals have come away with the rebound.
Yeah, and Coach Post said it at the end of our interview there. He's like, they need to just miss a few shots. This thing will turn around. They were red hot in the first half. I mean, just lights out shooting.
You get a team that hits 7 3-pointers and they're only averaging 3.7 a game, making 3.7 a game. That's a big turnabout right there.
Yeah, how about that? Dorsey with that pass and then the jam. Look at this, another view of it. And as you see it, Woodson's in no man's land. He's like, I got to take Dorsey. But as soon as I do, it's going to be wide open for the jam. And that kind of lifted that crowd and got the crowd into this thing a little bit. And they're trying to feed off of it.
And now the Cardinals come out in full court pressure defense.
See if they can make something happen on the trap here. Dorsey knocked it away off of him. And it'll be a Cardinal possession after the turnover.
Momentum has changed uniforms, Tim.
Yeah, momentum has changed uniforms. On the back of that jersey is old man Mo. So it's an 8-point ball game. They'll set the shot clock.
Look at the Cardinal body language, how it's dramatically changed from the first half.
Yeah, they definitely look like a different ball club here. Energy-wise, Bynum jump three. Knock it down! Bynum for three! Trinity Valley pulling within five here. Off to a great start in the second.
Bynum with 4 3-pointers now, 14 points in the contest.
Inside 17 minutes to go. Working hard defensively. Franklin on the low block, steps out, three, not there. Rebound, Franklin and Bayou will come away with it. Dorsey up the floor from the left side. Oh, Wood got tangled up.
Scratch that option.
Bynum going the other way. Gives way, kick out, three. Bayou for three, short. Franklin tried to keep it alive. Not much you could do with that. It ricocheted off of the rim so quickly.
Oh, what a just a change of momentum we've seen in this game real quick.
Yeah, and it can turn on a dime in Trinity Valley trying to bring in heat here. Coach Levinson getting the most out of his squad here, bringing life to this Cardinal team here in the second half. They trail by five to TJC. Down low they go. Dorsey going to be called for the foul. That'll be Mackay's second foul.
And looking for the tie-up, but he did get a little bit of his arm, grab the arm, so it's going to be a foul. Cardinals are down 14 at halftime, Tim. They're down five now.
That's a great start here in this second half, Trinity Valley. And you just keep thinking if they can keep this going, this crowd is going to give you a huge lift. They're into this game. Approaching the first 4 minutes, finalizing the first 4 minutes, and like you said, they've closed that lead by nine, almost knocked away.
And this game is now being played at a pace that's more advantageous to the Cardinals from the standpoint. They're averaging 80 points a game.
Wood with a strip, and it's 1 second on the shot clock. So they're going to have to get rid of it quickly.
No foul here. Do not bail them out.
Yeah, don't give them anything with a foul to keep this thing alive. So let's see what they do. Oh, too easy. He missed it at the...
I'm telling you, momentum has changed.
Oh, my goodness gracious. They were hitting them from 45 feet moments ago. Dorsey, jump stop, up, shot, won't go. Last touch by TJC. I believe it was Woodson that tapped it, tried to tap it back, tapped it up into the stands.
I'm telling you, the missing ingredient now is to get Mackay Dorsey involved offensively from a scoring standpoint.
Yeah, Mackay inbounding, finds Wood. Screen up top, Bynum catches, shoots, delivers! The postman coming up big with that one, knocking it down. How many threes is that? Number five for him. Still 15-20 to go here in the ball game. Kick out for three, left side, lets it go. Not this time, Wood is there. Braden up the floor.
TJC scored 2 points in this half.
Inside, out to Franklin. Passes off. He's been hot. Not this time. Getting back. Beat him down the floor, but Franklin hustling to get there.
Oh!
Blocking foul coming here.
He may have been set up too much underneath to go.
I was watching the way he landed. Okay, good. He's walking it off, but man, I look like he might have rolled up for a second.
Cardinals on a 14-2 run, Tim.
Yeah, look at that. Well, got the 14-2 run. Good point there. I just became a fan watching that on the replay for a second, as it's 14:50 to go here in the ball game. Cards in a timeout. 60-second time. Let's keep it here and talk about it.
Here's the great thing about it, too. The Cardinals have pretty much wiped out the deficit, but they haven't spent the entire half doing it.
Yeah.
So they've got some energy left.
Got a lot of energy, got a lot of gas in the tank, and this timeout probably comes at a pretty good time for them here. as they get a chance to, you know, kind of talk over what's going well for them.
Just how quickly the thing changed. And it's all starting with the play inside there that we saw.
2-point ball game with under 5 minutes and 10 seconds to go. They were down 14. The reason I remember that is because I said 2 touchdowns. They were down.
I'm not saying we had thrown in the towel, but we were writing the eulogy.
But you're right. It was points were coming very hard to get, and TJC was scoring in buckets.
Yeah.
Big old bushels of points.
And now I've scored 2 points in this first 5 minutes, the first 4.5 minutes of this half.
You said it. Coming into the second half, it would come off of defense, and they have tightened the defensive side of things. And then some of the hot shooting just had to eventually slow down. So they're going to get a crack at a couple of freebies here. Stepping to the free throw line, Brandon Walker. Walker gets the first one to go, so it's up to a 3-point contest.
Cardinal softball team just defeated Howard down in Waco 10-2.
I'm not going to comment on that.
No, please don't.
Congrats to the Lady Cards softball squad. Goes 1-2 there, so a 3 here could tie it up. Coach Levinson saying, push it. Let's get on the floor. Make it happen. Cisse. To telegraph that one. That's up to a 5-point game after the flush.
And that's how you reverse momentum if you're TJC.
It wasn't there. They gave away an opynnunity. Bynum putting on a show. Pulls up for 3. Bynum for 3. Block it down with that. That had the full package right there. The dribble, frees himself, and knocks it down. Well done. 2-point ball game.
And now those are contested 3-pointers.
I'm telling you, they were closing out on him. Franklin going to get called for a reach, I believe.
He's going to get called for a reach, but I thought there were steps taken as well.
Yeah, they will get Devin with his first foul of the ball game. He's got 7 points on the afternoon. But how about Bynum with that contested 3 after he frees himself with the dribble? Put on the whole display there.
No doubt.
Essence turned into a fun one here at historic Cardinal Gym. Leon Spencer Court throws it deep in the backcourt. Denham almost tracked it down. Now he feels like he's got a fast break with Denham trailing. Fun to watch when they got it going. Block inside. Denham Johnson now. Mbe with the rebound, and they go hard to the floor.
Very hard to the floor.
Tie-up situation here. Arrow favoring TJC. Well, there's a couple of bigs once momentum takes over. Speaking of momentum.
Made my stomach hurt when they fell on top of each other.
I was glad I was over here for that one. Sometimes I miss those playing days. But not in a moment like that. It's a fun one going on here at Cardinal Gym today. If you can't be here in person, glad to have you online. Here's a shot over the top. Not there. Yeah, that's a foul coming. I believe they're going to get Walker. Yeah, number 20, Brandon Walker with a little shove.
And those are the shots that were falling for TJC there in the first half.
So Brandon's picked up his third foul, too. So he's been a force down low.
He has.
Got to be careful with him. 2-point ball game, TJC and Trinity Valley.
Here. TJC jumped out to a 6-0 lead on 2-3 quarters to start the game and been in the lead ever since.
Yeah, they have been red hot for most of that first half. Here's a 3 from Phil March. Way off.
Good look at it, though.
Yeah, he got a good, clean look. He's going to say that was a pass. Staying alive. It'll be March on the pull down. Here he comes up the floor. He gives way to Bynum. Bynum had a blocking foul coming, so Knuckles will check in. Garrett.
I'm not sure what you do for TJC with Ahmad Bynum. They've had him double team sometimes, and he's put up 3-pointers and they're falling in.
All you can do is, like, really kind of like that half-court shot we saw a couple of minutes ago. Like, wow.
No surprise the young man started his college career at DePaul.
DePaul, man. Some of my best memories as a kid was watching DePaul. Just one of those perennials. There's a 3 from Bynum. Left that one short. Johnson tried to get there. That was a great just awareness by Hooper.
He climbed the back of Hooper to try to get there.
Tried to go around him. Couldn't quite get there. So Dorsey coming on for Bynum. Bynum has been red hot.
He has been, and now he's not on the floor, so somebody's going to have to pick up the slack for the Cardinal offense, and it needs to be Makai Dorsey.
Yeah, Dorsey's going to be working on the defensive side of things. Inside, 13 to go. Mbe almost knocked it away. Playing big-time defense, 30 feet from the basket. Cards have tightened it up. There's a shot. Nice touch from Hooper.
That was a big 9 one. Points in the contest.
P.J. Hooper, they needed that one. It had been a long time since they had anything positive offensively, and that was a clutch shot. Knuckles just into the ballgame, gets it down to Mbe.
Cardinals can't go stagnant here, Tim.
Garrett, corner, three, not there.
Cardinals can't go stagnant.
Boy, that was I thought that one was going to fall. Had a good look at it, couldn't get it to roll. A lot of hand checking out top. Trying to go inside Mbe. There defensively, Johnson pulls it down. Here come the Cardinals.
Good job of defending by the big man.
Working the perimeter around to Dorsey. Mbe's got him inside. They get it to him too easy. Big fella goes strong. Oh, blocked inside. What a play by number 22, Woodson. And
see, I don't know about calling that timeout.
Yeah, you're down to two now.
No, I thought TJC had called it. Well, they call a foul.
Foul on Mbe. So that'll be his second.
Wow. I thought TJC had called, had burned a timeout. They put him down to one.
Wow.
With a lot of time left.
Inside the 12-minute mark. So we got a media timeout when it's all said and done. It's a 4-point ball game here in Athens. Stick around. More coming up after this on the Cardinals Sports Network.
Welcome to Trinity Valley Community College, home of the mighty Cardinals, offering hands-on education with an average teacher-to-student ratio of 1 to 20 at a third of the price of regional institutions. We teach, we strive, we succeed. TVCC, it makes sense. Apply today at tvcc.edu.
Our crispy, juicy, tender chicken sandwich can make you feel a lot of things. The spicy one can make you feel, what's the word? Tingly? Yeah, tingly. McDonald's spicy, crispy chicken sandwich. Order ahead on the app.
Welcome back, Cardinal Sports Network here as Trinity Valley has come out with all the energy in the second half, Benny.
They have, Tim. It's a point in the game now, though, where they don't need to go stagnant on offense.
Yeah,
they've worked real hard defensively to get back in the contest, and the offense has paid dividends, but you can't go quietly now.
Yeah, you got to be real careful. You get a look there at that last foul. It got pretty intense down on the floor, so they'll be keeping an eye on those two. Phil March on the ball defensively for the Cardinals working. That's one thing Trinity Valley has done extremely well in the second half. Knuckles going to be called for the foul here.
He is, Tim, and that's going to be the 16th foul against the Cardinals. So at this rate, TJC is going to shoot a lot of free throws.
Yeah, 11:29 to go in the ballgame. That is. But boy, they've been battling here to get back in it. Fadeaway shot. Won't go. Rebound. Denham Johnson pulls it down. March brings it up the floor. Like you said, Cards need to keep that keep things going offensively as they came out really a point. Back door! Denham Johnson with the slam. How about the pass, though?
Phil March.
My goodness. Phil with the assist. And Denham Johnson just coming back baseline. Putting it down.
Denham's had a strong outing today, offensively and defensively.
Well done there. 2-point ball game. Cards trying to get it going, or keep it going, rather.
Crowd trying to lift them up as well.
Yeah, indeed. There's a drive, shot, the floater short.
Oh, he's going to sleep on the backside.
Oh, man, that's a great reaction there from Simon Johnson.
Yeah, it's his first points of the contest as well.
Back to a 4-point game. Dorsey. Back to Mbe. Mbe. Oh, they missed Denham down low. He gets down low himself, though. kisses it off the backboard. Two-pointer, and it's a two-point game.
The big man decides he's going to go. He's going to go.
He says we can do it the easy way or we can do it the hard way, but we're going to do this.
We're going to do this.
And it usually works
good
out.
Good line, Tim.
Usually works out. Inside 10 minutes to go in this ball game. It's a two-point game.
Got a ball game.
All Trinity Valley here in the second half. Johnson defensively good. Good
shot. A lot of contact there. Mike Marcus is asking the official about that right now.
Jason Jones Taylor, boy.
Good guy, you're bald just like I am. Where's the call?
That was a bucket and a half there, man.
Yeah,
that was strong. Franklin will come on for Trinity Valley at the next stop of play. Phil March for three. It's a one-point game. His first points of the game and a big time here in the second half.
Cardinals get inched ever so closer.
That's out of bounds off of...
And March comes with a defensive play.
B.J. Hooper. So what a moment there for March.
No doubt about it. And listen to the crowd.
And then gets the stop defensively. And now here comes in the ballgame Franklin for Denham Johnson. So on the floor right now, you got Dorsey, Franklin, Phil March, Mbe, and Knuckles.
And you know Bynum's somewhere close to coming back into the contest.
He's got a good spell. Here's a drive. The shot is good, and the one opportunity. That'll give Trinity Valley the lead.
I told you he had to get involved.
Yeah, he does come through at the 9-10 mark there. But like you said, he's had a couple of nice passes to get the oop going and the defensive stops, and now 6 points here in the ballgame. Chance to make it 7. Here it comes in your screen on the replay. Drew the contact from Hooper, and now trying to make it a three-point play with 9-10 to go.
Cardinals down 46-32 at half, and at the 9-10 mark, take a lead 58-57.
I'll let Benny do the math on that for
no,
you.
No, we're not doing any math there.
Math is not here, but no math dad there as he leaves it on the front iron. So Trinity Valley with a one-point lead over TJC. All Trinity Valley in the second half, they were down 14. Now with a one-point advantage going strong, gets the bucket, and it's back to an advantage for TJC.
Yeah, credit TJC coming right back at the Cardinals, taking it all in low from point-blank range.
Knuckles gets it to him. Big fella says, hey, feed me. Oh, they're going to call him for steps.
Well, he does do that sometimes.
Felt like he might have been knocked off the mark there, though, is what he's saying. Reason I took steps. Into the ball game, you called it. Bynum wasn't far behind. And good run there for March. Phil March comes on, plays lights out defense, a couple of big baskets as well.
It was instrumental in the comeback.
So here come the Cardinals down one after they took a lead moments ago. TJC answered. Now trying to build on it themselves. Knocked away. Dorsey. Oh, they're going to get it over and back.
There's got to be something called. He's sliding.
Right there, Dorsey, number three. Hustling. Makai Dorsey getting things happening as Coach Marquis is got to be looking at his team saying, okay, fellas, we've worked too hard to get this thing back to them here.
And sometimes when you're down on your luck, you know, no matter what you do, you just stay down on your luck.
Dorsey, little shift step, goes high. The putback is good, and a foul.
Now they're going to call a something with the
waving it off.
Foul.
They're waving it off. No basket. Count the basket. Foul's going to be on MBA for a push. No basket. And so fouls now, free throws the rest of the way.
At the 8:04 mark, TJC is at the free throw line. Mark it down.
1-1 the rest of the way. So free throws at the 8:04 mark. That's a long time to shoot free throws as Trinity Valley is called for the push. At the stripe, it'll be Hudson Anderson. Missed it. The front end is no good.
Yeah, that's an opportunity for TJC. Those will add up. They won't add up.
Knuckles thought about a three. Now they swing at Franklin. Right side. Devin Franklin for three. Putting it down.
Devin with 10 points. His second three-pointer. That's our man right there, Devin Franklin.
We said it. If they could get this crowd up into it, they're ready to explode, and they have. It's a two-point
game. Devin Franklin with the steal.
Franklin with the steal. Franklin going coast to coast. gives way, and it's going to be touched by the Apaches. That'll be Cardinal basketball. Devin, big smile going, hey, not my finest moment, but hey, you kept it alive.
Have I said this before?
You
I
said it.
I love me some Devin Franklin.
Well, you haven't only said it, but you've got the tattoo on the left bicep.
No.
That's a joke, folks. No. I'm sorry.
Definitely a joke.
61-59, Trinity Valley up two. We'll step away.
We better.
After this. Coming up on the Cardinals Sports Network.
TJC. Here's how it goes. This is you. You're ready to choose your path. This is us. One of the top colleges in the nation. And it's only a third of the cost of most state schools. You apply. You get in. You choose a major. Maybe engineering. Perhaps musical theater. Or nursing. Or power plant technology. At TJC, we've got it all. With more than 120 degree programs and certificates. You get involved. Play for the team. Beat the drum. All while getting the education you need. Tyler Junior College. You're ready for this.
What a fun afternoon in Athens, Texas. It's Trinity Valley and Tyler Junior College. The Highway 31 rivalry never disappoints.
It doesn't. It's been a good day for Trinity Valley. Lady Cardinals winning 77-52 over Angelina. The softball team beating Howard 10-2. About to play McClellan down in Waco. Now the Cardinals have rallied from a 14-point halftime deficit with 7:35 left to go up 61-59.
Boy, I'm telling you, this has been a great afternoon of hoops. And TJC was about as hot as a team could be in the first half. They were shooting beyond great. And they continued that must of the half. But Trinity Valley came out defensively and set the tone. And that's where we're at now.
And that's the reason we're at. You're right. You're exactly right.
Dorsey bringing the inbound. Trying to set it up over on the right side. Couple of screens up top. Good defense from the Apaches.
Yeah, they know they can't let Makai Dorsey drive.
10 on the shot clock. Knuckles lets it fly from three. Garrett Knuckles for three. Lifting this crowd into it. Trinity Valley is pulling away up five now. Pulling away is not the word I meant, but putting some things together for the Valley.
There's some distance there anyway.
Mbe out defensively.
Look at Knuckles working defensively inside down low.
Making them work. There's eight on the shot clock. Apaches for three on the other end. Not there. Franklin pulls it down. Dorsey will bring it up the floor. Trinity Valley is
They're doing what the number 12 ranked team should do at home.
Yeah, they're protecting that home court. But, man, TJC looked like a different ball club in the first half. And so did Trinity Valley.
Yeah.
They have switched roles. You said it. Momentum has changed jerseys in the second half. 6:27.
Oh,
and Bay.
He's grabbing him.
Down low, the foul. There's a reason he took a step that time. It was the foul on number 20. For Anderson, he'll step out. Hudson Anderson stepping out, 6'8 sophomore. So back into the ball game, number 20, big fella Brandon Walker.
If you're the Cardinals, you can stay aggressive, Tim. You continue to attack offensively.
Mbe on the inbound. Bynum, step back for three. Bynum for three. He is in flagro right now.
I'm going to say this. The man's indefensible, Tim. He's indefensible.
Yeah, that's one of the things you look at the film. You're like, you can't play defense any better than that. And that's a good, strong move on the other end from Jermonte Hall.
TJC needed that answer. They were down eight at that point. 6 minutes to go. Cardinals up 67-51.
There's a foul coming. They'll get Loudon on the running up on the backside of them there.
And that'll be the 16th foul against TJC. So the Cardinals on the next Tyler foul will be in the bonus as well. So that'll even out.
5:59 to go in this one. Long way still.
10 Cardinals have scored in this one.
Bynum is going to find Franklin. Goes up strong. He's fouled. He'll go to the free throw line as it's going to be two free throws for Devin Franklin.
Yeah, Devin will go to the free throw line with 10 points on the strength of 2 3-pointers. He's also hit 2 free throws in the contest. He's got 22 3-pointers on the season now.
So Brandon Walker, guilty of the foul. He's got 4 here in this ball game. I say keep attacking that big man down low and get a good pass off underneath.
And both teams will be shooting free throws the rest of the way.
It's 5:50 to go. Franklin's free throw is good.
Wins it 68-61. TVCC looking like a different ball club here in the second half. Much of this crowd on their feet. At least the student body is on both sides of the gym. Two for two. Franklin makes it an 8-point contest. TVCC has won. Has climbed all the way back up to the lead in Region 14. Starting to say they've won four in a row.
They've won three in a row.
Three in a row. Good drive.
TVCC, to their credit, has found an answer. Three straight possessions anytime the Cardinals have gone up by eight or more.
So, yeah, as you alluded to, that three in a row, they had that big win over Panola a week ago. Here's a three on the way. Not there.
Maybe not well advised, to be honest with you. Probably should have looked for another option.
Yeah, still had time in the shot clock. Blocking foul coming on. Is it going to be on Knuckles and Bay?
Yeah, that's going to be a one and one because he was passing off. That's four fouls now on the big man.
Big fella with his fourth. He's going to have to be real careful here.
Tyler's going to need to convert at the free throw line. He missed the front end of the first one and one opportunity that they had.
Mentioned that Cisse, Mamadou Cisse, is not available today. So, Mbe will take a seat for the time being. Missed that.
Tyler lifts another 2 points, 4 points now at the free throw line, Tim.
Boy, those are frustrating moments when you're trying to. 5 minutes to go here in the ball game at five even. They're going to put 25 on the shot clock.
Yeah, it didn't start.
So with a inbound, Cards up six with 5 minutes to go after being down 14.
If you're the Cardinals, stay aggressive. Don't get deliberate.
That's a 20-point swing. Even I can do the math on that one. Reverse layup, not there. Franklin being pushed out of bounds, perhaps. Cisse had it knocked away. Pass out front. Knuckles trying to defend. Ball is missed underneath, but a foul coming on a loose Cisse.
He got the most of that foul.
He earned his
foul
there.
Got his money's worth.
Well, they're going to call it on Knuckles. 1-0. I guess got him down on the block underneath.
Two-shot foul.
Mitchell gets the first to go.
He's got 12 points now.
Johnson comes on. Bynum will sit.
Not for long.
Yeah, they'll give him a little spell here with the 4:34 mark.
It won't be a long break.
So Phil March, Makai Dorsey, Devin Franklin, Denham Johnson, and Alou Cisse on the floor in gray. Cardinals up by four with 4:34 to go. Long way to go in this one.
TVC's still going to feel okay with things right now. They've withstood their storm, I think.
Yeah, they have. It's going to see who finishes this thing off. Wide open three. Phil, a little stutter step.
Phil March for two. Phil March coming up big for the Cardinals. Defensively in on the offensive end.
Phil is feeling it today. Cards working hard here, up six. 4 minutes to go. Thought about a three. Drive shot is short. Loose ball picked up finally by Denham Johnson. Johnson on the push. Goes up. Had it knocked away. Great defense from Hooper. Back down the floor. Easy layup on the other end. That was all great defense on the other end. Got a dagger down the 94 feet away.
Yeah, I like the way TJC is hanging in there, Tim. They're battling back. Every time the Cardinals get a 6 or 8 point lead, they found an answer every time.
How about this afternoon of basketball? What a fun one, man. This is definitely Region 14 money. Franklin shoots. Not going to get the roll. Rebound is taken this time by Loudon. Baseball pass. Baseline. Foul coming on Dorsey, I believe. No, number 11. That'll be on March. So free throws on the way here. And a chance to pull within two if they can convert a couple of free throws at the 3:20 mark. A timeout on the floor. Full timeout. We'll step away. More after this on the Cardinals Sports Network.
Prosperity Bank offers free checking. Let's take a look. No monthly maintenance fee? Check. No individual check fees? Check. Free debit card? Check. Unlimited withdrawals? Check. Free online banking? Check. Easy access and friendly service? Check. Close to home? Check. Simply free checking from Prosperity Bank is simply free. I'm taking these checks to the bank. Prosperity is the big bank with your community's bank inside. Prosperity Bank, where you find real bankers, not just a bank.
Welcome back, Trinity Valley athletes. Baylor Scott and White Texas Spine and Joint Sports Medicine is here to keep you going at full force. Our commitment to helping athletes perform at their best on and off the field is our core strength. Whether it's orthopedics, performance, or wellness, physician-owned Baylor Scott & White Texas Spine & Joint Hospital is your choice for better health in East Texas. Just like every hard-driving Cardinal, we're focused on excellence every day.
Cardinal Sports Network in our 15th year. Boy, this is about as good as it as any of those over 15 years. It's been a fun one, hasn't it?
Oh, it's been a great one. Cardinals down 14 at the half, have been up as much as 8 here down the stretch. But this is a critical point right now because TJC is fighting back.
Boy, man, I got to tell you right now, both of these teams are, it's going to come down to who's got anything left in the tank because both of them have been hot, red hot at some point in this game. So how will this one end? Well, the first one is good by B.J. Hooper Jr. If you're just getting here, man, you should get here earlier.
Where the heck you been?
This has been a fun one. Maybe some folks might have stepped away because it didn't start out that kind of red, cardinal red that we like to see. But that's why they play two halves.
Mike Bottoms back on the floor for the Cardinals. Though, so that's the very offensive lineup out there now, not in a negative way.
Exactly. Dorsey, Bynum, Bayou, Johnson, and Franklin. You missed the second. They're leaving free throws on the point.
5 points at the free throw line, and we got a 2-point, 3-point ball game.
Oh, man. That's difference maker. Dorsey picked up defensively that time by Jones Taylor.
They have really done a good job of denying Makai the drives today.
3 minutes to go. Denham with 10 on the clock. Walks him down in trouble. They're going to get him on the baseline.
Oh, my goodness. He left himself no option.
Got in trouble down in the lane there and stepped on that baseline.
I think he was counting on the defender dropping off and double teaming, and he could dish it off for the two-man game. We saw the Lady Cardinals execute very well today.
2:45 to go. 3 to tie it. Does just that. That's a big one from Darius Woodson.
First three-pointer of the second half for TJC, 8th of the game.
Boy, they have been quiet in the second half, but had some big clutch threes, and that one was a massive one. It's a tie game with 2.5 to go. Dorsey over to Bayou. 10 on the clock. That guy, Dorsey, trying to back him down, trapped, and a whistle with 5 seconds left.
I want to credit what's going away from the ball. Number 3, Jackin Jones Taylor, is inside Ahmad Bynum's uniform.
Yeah, Jason Jones.
He's not going to touch the ball. Ahmad is not going to touch the ball the way TJC's playing this.
I think that came from Coach Marquez, is saying, hey, we are not going to let him beat us. You've got to be there.
Well, Jones Taylor was all over him.
He has been playing some lights out D on that position for sure. Dorsey gets the first one to go.
Well, all of these are going to count down the stretch, aren't they?
They will be huge. Trinity Valley up by 1 with 2:15 to go in this very heated rivalry through the years. TJC was all TJC in the first half. It's been all Trinity Valley in the second half. But TJC battling back after the Cards got it up to 8 at one point. Trinity Valley trailed by 14 at the break. Shot over the top is good. This is a fun one. Woodson lights it up himself.
This is good stuff, folks.
Tanya, Region 14 at its finest here this afternoon. TJC and Trinity Valley working inside a minute 40. Go strong. Bynum had it stripped off by Hooper.
Yeah, Hooper's now on Bynum. Not playing quite as tightly as Jones Taylor did.
That was a great setup that time, too, to free him going around the baseline.
Now so, Jones Taylor's back on Bynum.
You've also got into the ball game the big man with four fouls. Mbe gives it off to Bynum. Franklin, Dorsey, they go to Devin. Devin trying to find the big man, threw it away down low. He didn't have position established. I think that's what Mbe's saying. He's going down the floor. I wasn't there. Johnson with a steal. Denham Johnson out front to Bynum. Bynum goes up, draws contact off the glass. No foul. Loose ball. Here comes TJC on the other end. Shot short. Dorsey pulls it down, and Johnson will take it. He's going to go attack the basket. Gives way.
Well, they're in such a hurry. They don't need. There's no need to be in that big a hurry.
Timeout's going to be taken here. Trinity Valley has given it up with 1:03 to go. Cardinals and Apaches tied 73 apiece. It's a full timeout. We're going to step away for 30 seconds. We'll be back with more after this on the Cardinals Sports Network.
Your team leaves everything on the field. They play with heart and with their mind. But being smart starts long before the kickoff. With the latest technology, sports medicine advancements, expert physicians, we can keep your team healthy and protect joints and growing bones. For this big moment and their future on any field. Physician-owned Baylor Scott & White Texas Spine and Joint Hospital.
1:03 to go in this one, and we're back where we started about 2 hours ago.
TJC led 14 at the half. The Cardinals led to 8 about 3 minutes ago, and now we're tied at 73. This one's up for grabs, man.
Yeah, it is anybody's ball game at this point. 1:03 to go. TJC with possession. Cardinals have 2 timeouts at their disposal. TJC has 1 left here in regulation.
That could be huge down the stretch.
So here comes the defense of Trinity Valley. Loudon brought it down the floor. They've got 15 on the shot clock. Mbe daring him to shoot the 3. Whoop. Rattles out. Kept alive on the baseline, then stolen away by Jason Jones-Taylor. Foul is going to be on Dorsey.
Dorsey coming to a little game.
So
he had an ankle issue.
That's his 4th foul. The guy will sit as
it's down on the floor now. Had to the bench, but went to the floor. Officials haven't seen that yet.
He's got a shoe issue.
Oh, his first free throw attempt is good by Hooper. They need a little good march in the lineup.
They're going to go take a look at Dorsey over on the training table here.
Well,
so it's a
one-point
game.
Yeah, keep it here, Tim. It's 74-73 with another free throw to come for TJC. 37.9 seconds left.
You got potentially a two-point ball game here, 37 seconds. 30-second shot clock. So Trinity Valley is going to have a look at it. They cannot, you know, shoot a 3 to win it.
No, TJC. They can't play for the final shot.
Right.
There's no doubt they're going to get the ball in Ahmad Bynum's hands, but obviously TJC is going to try to deny that. So we've got to have option 2 ready to go.
Yeah, TJC on the year is 14-10, 6-8 in conference play. They've lost 5 straight. They want to upend Trinity Valley, who's sitting atop region 14 and went a long way to get there in the first half before Trinity Valley came back. That's where we got to this point, and what is happening now?
No doubt about it, Tim. As I like the way that TJC has answered every time the Cardinals have been up 6 or 8 points in this second half.
Yeah,
they've answered every time.
This has been two heavyweights slugging back and forth, trading blows, if you will.
Well, TJC's played like a heavyweight today, that's for sure.
They have. They've been battling. So, free throw, the second one. This is a huge free throw.
What a win this would be for Mike Marcus and his Apaches if they can pull this off against the 12th-ranked Cardinals at home floor.
Gets it to fall, so it's a two-point ball game. They give it to Bynum. He'll bring it up the floor. 35 seconds to go in regulation.
The ball might not leave his hands. Well, it does.
Bill March. March has had a big second half. 20 on the clock, shot clock, about a 5-second differential. Bill trying to create, gets up, shoots over the top, not there, out of bounds on the Apaches. Cards are going to have another crack at it.
Cardinals catch a break. 9 seconds on the shot clock.
Yeah, you've got to get something early here. Probably a timeout coming. Yeah, Coach Levinson going to burn one here. Marty Levinson will take a timeout.
Be his last one.
He uses his last one here. 9 seconds on the shot clock. We'll step away. 30-second timeout. More after this on the Cardinals Sports Network.
No one ever said you need to be sick to get better. That's why at Baylor Scott & White, we're innovating how people get well and stay that way. Where prevention might just be the prescription.
Way to work.
Teaching is on the treatment plan.
That's what I'll do.
And everyone is always on the same team.
Good girl.
Yours. Baylor Scott & White Health, changing healthcare for the better.
Well, what a fun one this afternoon. Can all double hitters be this good? Because if they are, we got another one scheduled for you next weekend. Lady Cards versus Panola, 2 o'clock. We'll have that here on the Cardinals Sports Network. And then the Cardinals versus Kilgore. That'll be a huge one. 4 o'clock start on that. 16 seconds to go, but 9 on the shot clock.
Nine on the shot clock. I would not be surprised if Cardinals go for a three-pointer here, try to get this thing won in regulation.
Bynum for three. Bynum from the corner. Not there. Mbe had a chance. Franklin shoots. Not going to get it away with 3 seconds. They got to hurry, and it's going to be TJC. Nobody there to foul him, and a dunk to finish it. It's a four-point game with 4.4 to go. They get it to Knuckles. He'll get it off to Franklin at the buzzer for three, and that's how it ends. Cards are going to have that one slip right out of their hands. What a game this afternoon. TJC gets the W on the road.
It probably ended the way – by all rights, it should have ended based on the way the first half went, Tim, although the Cardinals fought their way back into it. It had an 8-point lead on two occasions late in the game, about the 6-minute mark, and couldn't hold on to it. And TJC's going to get out of here with a 77-73 win to break a 5-game losing streak and improve to 15-10 on the season, 7-8 in conference play. The Cardinals are going to fall to 20-5, 11-3 in conference play, and obviously their number 12 national ranking is going to fall just a bit this next week.
A lot of athleticism on display today. Short side for the Cards. They will fall by four. We will look forward again to this doubleheader coming up next Saturday, our next Cardinals broadcast. Lady Cards versus Panola. That'll start at 2 p.m. We'll get on the air about 12:45 for that, or 1:45 rather, and then the Cardinals and Kilgore next Saturday afternoon at 4 o'clock. Final thoughts, Benny?
Well, disappointing the Cardinals lose at home to a team that's lost 5 in a row, but I know I said it a couple of times, and I won't repeat it anymore, obviously, because we're about to sign off, but every now and then you have a lemon,
yeah.
And today kind of had a lemon feel to it.
Boy, a lot of good moments, but just not enough of them. Cards fall, come up short today. Thanks for joining us here. For Benny Rogers, I'm Tim Howard. Good afternoon for everyone that made this one happen. Join us next week on the Cardinal Sports Network.